There is a solution. Here's how a patent pool could work. Companies give their HIV patents to an independent organization called a patent pool. The pool then acts like a one-stop patent shop. Companies and researchers can access patents in exchange for a fair royalty payment to the inventors.
In December 2009, Médecins Sans Frontières welcomed the idea of setting up a patents pool for medicines. And an important milestone has just been reached. The first patent has been contributed to this mechanism.
An important institute, the National Institutes of Health, the principal body of public research in the United States, has offered to this patent pool the patent that they own on the antiretroviral drug darunavir.
Although this single patent isn't enough, it's a first step towards the production of this HIV medicine at lower cost for developing countries.
For the moment, it doesn't allow us to do anything because additional patents of the drug darunavir are still held elsewhere, in particular by Tibotec, owned by the American company Johnson & Johnson. But we will often find ourselves in these situations where there are several patents for a drug. So it's important that the other holders also put the rights to their patents in the pool.
It's an important move forwards. If others follow the example, it will help develop new combinations of drugs and make treatments for HIV/AIDS more accessible.
MSF welcomes this announcement because it really is an important gesture and encourages a public organization to offer its licenses to this patent pool. Furthermore, it incites, it puts more pressure on the pharmaceutical companies to give access to their patents.
MSF currently treats over 160,000 people with HIV/AIDS. 80% of ARVs used in NGO projects are produced by generic drug companies in India.